the whole country. Each one of us is affected by the question of the parliament. There are rules followed in the parliament based on democratic principles to ensure that everybody gets the chance to be heard and a proper decorum is made in the course of the session that will be in the parliament. In today's debate, competition from different institutions, 14 teams will represent the government and 30 teams will stand for the opposition. So now, with due respect, I would like to call our jury members that are present with us today for the evening. As I welcome and give a brief about each one of them, I kindly request the students volunteer to kindly facilitate our respective.
I welcome all the members of the House in this new Parliament session. I hope this session will be useful, productive, and will be carried on with utmost dignity and discipline. So, the first item in the list of business is oath and affirmation. Secretary General, please.
from institutions have been elected as a member of the Youth Parliament, do solemnly affirm that I bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of India as by law established, and I will uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India, and I will be faithful to discharge the duty upon which I am about to enter.
In favor of rural population and the rest in favor of urban population. Now let me explain why I am putting these statistics in favor of this argument. Madam Speaker, the basic argument which the government puts forward in terms of abolishing reservation is the fact that discrimination does not exist, and that is the whole reason so as to why we need to put an end to reservation. But Madam Speaker, if you look at the cases, we can rightfully see that reservation as a policy is something which we need in this country at this point of time. Because, you know, every day we are seeing cases of discrimination against people of various castes. It is very easy for people living in metropolitan cities to, you know, say that reservation is not required on the basis that, on the basis that they take the case study of certain families who have benefited from the reservation policy, and taking that as a case example, they speak for the millions of people who are discriminated in villages in states like Maharashtra, Gujarat and Karnataka. The most hypocritical part is recently in Maharashtra, in the same village wherein B.R. Ambedkar started his revolt against this discrimination, so certain people were not allowed to have water from the same well as the upper caste, and that, ladies and gentlemen, is happening in the 21st century. So reservation should end. That is something all of us should agree. But it is not the perfect time in our country to end reservation, because if we do it now, then we do not have a proper precedent and we do not have a structure so as to how this country would function without reservation. The government would, in my opinion, the government would talk about how reservation should be based on economic disparity rather than caste. My question is, why can't we do both? Why do we need to suffer the people who are economically backward and then give that to the caste-based reservation or the other way forward? Why cannot we do both? Because both these groups of people are suffering in their own way. And if we deny the people who are suffering because of their caste and give them to the people who are suffering because of the economic background, then we are just putting it to some other group. What we need is we need to find something which would help both these groups. And that is my question to the government, Madam Speaker.
Thank you. But we have to look at the fact that reservation system now doesn't just do a fair job, acts as a form of justice to all who are, in a sense, marginalized because of their economic problems, because of their educational problems. Reservation now have, in a sense, been an unjust, let me see, you say, by people from reserved communities. And reservation has become a caste. Reservation has become a square. It should have been the policy to uplift people from caste, to bring them as a united front.
Hello. from 5,000 generations, but in the period of 70 years when this reservation policy is applied in India, no change has been occurred. Like, yeah, some reasons we have that people have get a lot of help from this policy, but there are many drawbacks of this system. This system has created a new caste system where ST, OBC,
Do you remember the opposition?